Hello everyone, I'm Hilary Chin. Thank you all so much for coming and watching my YouTube channel. Today I want to share with us some of the reasons why online companies can maybe draw back for some time before they come on. And that is what we are facing now. We are with our OES, and many people have reached out to me with a concern that the OES has been drawn, and they are worried that what's going on, etc. We'll be discussing about that. But before we get there, I just want to share with you some of our services that are available right now. We can do this online. We are doing it virtually. If you have businesses across the globe, Cameroon, USA, UK, and you want us to analyze those data for you, please, you can reach out to us. You might have a supermarket. You might be selling and having customers that are coming in and you don't understand which product specifically is making profit, which area is doing well, and which area is not doing well. All what we need is that data, or we can create a data system for you or a data warehouse for you where those information, we craft questions that relate to your business where customers can respond, and then those that data come in and then we are able to analyze for you. Okay, if you're also a student who is doing research or a researcher and you want us to analyze your data, you can send it to us. Remember, I'm a data scientist or data analyst, and we use different tools across the board. We use Cobalt Toolbox, we use Excel, we use SQL, we use Power BI, we use Tableau. All these tools are used to analyze data and visualize those data for you. Okay, we are going to customize that for you and discuss bilaterally. And also, we are now be website. We have a website service. If you want to build a website, you can reach out to us. We have someone who is really expertise on that. But before we get again into the crux of the matter, please, I just want to thank you all who have been sharing and following me for I think 2 years or 1.5 now. I really appreciate. Okay, and now we get into the matter. First of all, I want us to understand that onpassive is a business that is building, that is growing. In my previous video, I emphasized that onpassive is a business that is, first of all, putting its roots on the ground to stand firm. Oh, you can compare onpassive like this. You can take a mango tree and a pawpaw tree. Okay, these are two different kinds of tree. But if you plant these two trees, the pawpaw tree will grow very fast, produce fruits very fast, and then die fast. That I liken it to pyramidal scams that are online. Now, when you look at a mango tree, it takes a long time. Why? The mango tree first grows downward before it grows upward. The pawpaw tree just grows upward. That is why when the mango tree takes a long time to grow, once it begins to produce, it produces for a long, long time. Okay, so that's how you should look at onpassive. And of course, systems like onpassive or every other system like Microsoft, etc. Okay, especially onpassive, sometimes they can have a challenge in terms of maybe they realize that there is some kind of fishy activities within the system. They will withdraw the system at the time. They don't need to inform you guys. The time they have to use to inform you, the system must have been affected to a point where even if they draw it back, it is going to kill the business. Remember that we are online. Do you know how many people are trying to hack onpassive? Do you know how many people are trying to hack onpassive? There are many people who are working day out, day in to hack the system, okay? And that is why sometimes you realize that onpassive will stop some tools. You just see some challenges with some tools. That is not because onpassive is incompetent, no. Sometimes they might just test some tools. And onpassive is made up of so many different departments, okay? And these departments are working in collaboration. And in the course of working, if they realize that one department is having a challenge, they're going to draw the system back. Now, we saw Ash was really talking and giving his worries regarding how he wanted things to go fast, and now things are not that fast, which to me is very not okay, but common in many businesses, especially when the business is genuine. And you must understand that now that the system has been withdrawn, it was not withdrawn because they just wanted to withdraw the system. Instead, when you see a system withdrawn like that, it means there's a lot of work and restructuring going on. A lot of work and restructuring. And you must know that the onpassive system is in the cloud system. Okay? It's hosted in cloud. Okay? So when they finish, they're going to host it back. That's how it works. I don't want to go into details, start giving you some tech terms and all that stuff. But just know basically that the system is hosted in cloud. Okay? And they can withdraw the system. It's like your website. Okay? When you build your website and then you host it. Okay? You pay an amount and then they host it. So you can host it online and you can build your website and keep it in your machine and just have the template in your machine. And then there's the time you can host it. So that's the same thing that onpassive is doing. And why it is hosted there, there's money that they pay and so on and so forth. And amazingly, Ash has already confirmed that we have our data center. We have been registered in ICANN. And this amazing, amazing, amazing breakthrough that every onpassivian needs to sit every day and thank God for it. So please don't be scared, don't be worried. Just know that whatever action you see taken in onpassive is for the good of the customers. And many times I always ask onpassive founders and athletes, okay, I want you to look at the online business, the online landscape. You must understand that Ash wants this to work more than you want it. That's how simple it is. It's a business model. Okay, it's like you take your product in the market and you are trying to think how best you can make it for people to buy. So different minds can go to the market. There's a mind in the market that is just casual. Well, anyhow, you buy, you don't buy. There's another mind that is average, okay? I want this to be nice for people to buy. There's another mind that is extremely good. They want to see their product so good. Remember that mind will always have challenges, okay? They want to see their product so good. And for that reason, they'll go through a lot of challenges. They'll go through a lot of all kinds of things because they are passionate to see that their product is the best. And as they start looking forward to that, those other minds that are casual will begin to attack. Okay? They will not focus on becoming best. They will focus on attacking. So there are so many things that are going on. And you must understand that Ash specifically is for humanity. And it's not all the team that understands these realities. Okay? Some people just came there to make money. We're not business. But Ash has a different mindset. He has a different goal. And it doesn't make the other people bad, no. It just makes them human and also shows that every human being has their own mission on earth and they have their own vision, okay? And that is why you hear Ash saying that now he wants to take control over things. That is why, if you notice, since onpassive started, we have not really had this situation where the system is drawn back. So the moment Ash says, I want to take control, the system now is drawn back. That is to tell you that something unique is going on. And from his own words, he has stated it clear that everything they are doing is for our benefit, and which is true, we've seen it over the years. And of course, like I always told you guys, every genuine business go through the stages, okay? Every time I see the stages, I just laugh and I thank God. It's genuine. That's one thing you should keep in mind. So don't be worried, don't be scared. Everything is perfect, everything is under control. Let's just keep praying and hoping that we all have good health. So let's pray, guys. Those of you out there who are sick, if you are sick of any infirmity, you have any challenge, wherever you are, please, I'm praying in the name of Jesus, okay? And you yourself, you know the name of the sickness, just join me and just say this with me. Father, in the name of Jesus, whatever sickness that I have in my body, Father, Lord, I ask you to heal me this moment in the mighty name of Jesus. Some of you don't know why we pray in the name of Jesus, okay? The scripture says that that name is above all power, is above all principality, is above all sickness, okay? And that by the at the mention of that name, at the mention of that name, every knee, every sickness bows, okay? And we don't just mention the name casually. We mention it in faith, okay? It's a mystery, guys. It's a mystery, okay? And if you're healed out there, please don't thank me. Please thank Jesus. All the glory goes to him. All the glory. If you read your scriptures very well, Jesus always gave the glory to the Father. Paul always gave the glory to Jesus, okay? It is always going to him because he's the one doing it. We are just vessels. We are just like containers. When your container you used to drink water, yes. We are ngongong. Yeah, we are ngongong. For instance, if I give you a cup of water to drink, you are going to appreciate the water, not the cup. And also, you are going to appreciate the one that gave you that water to drink, not the cup. So I am the cup, okay? So you cannot appreciate me. So the glory goes back to Jesus. Thank you all so much and stay blessed and keep thanking God for onpassive. It's a done deal. Ciao, ciao.